Now, it's hard to believe it is more than a decade since Olly Murs burst onto our screens as a young, hopeful contestant on The X Factor.
Since then, he's gone on to create 4 number one albums, perform across the world and become a familiar face on our TV screens.
Now, for the first time in 4 years, he's launching a brand new record. He's going to be heading back on tour. We're going to chat to him here on the sofa.
Oh, that's right. I'm not sure the missus would like it.
Oh, Olly, as you can tell, everyone, Olly's here with us now. We're just chatting about that white suit.
Yeah, I like that. I might have it for the wedding. What are we saying?
Yeah. No, congratulations on the engagement.
Thank you. Yeah, no, I don't think the missus would be happy with that.
Why not?
Because she wears... She's going to be wearing white.
Do you
or
think
cream,
you might take
she?
The shine off a
yeah,
bit?
Yeah, yeah.
Don't do that.
Standard black suit, I think.
Oh, I like
Tucked
it.
Maybe, something like that.
You've planned quite a lot already, haven't you, for your wedding?
I've got to stop talking about it.
Yeah, you have?
Yeah, no, we have, actually. It's been a lot of planning, yeah. Since we got engaged in June, yeah, we've been doing lots of... It's crazy, isn't it?
Yeah.
So stressful.
But it can be fun as well, can't
no,
it?
Yeah, but it's... I mean, me and Amelia, we've been together, what, 3.5 years, and we have, like, the odd little spat. But since we've got engaged and started planning a wedding, we're having more little arguments, you know what I mean? And, like, having a little bit like, oh, you haven't told me about this yet. You haven't approved this yet. You haven't given me an answer from this yet. You know?
Olly, it doesn't matter, does it? It doesn't matter what colour the napkins are or...
I didn't think I cared about that, but I do. That's the weirdest thing.
You're
I'm like,
groomzilla.
No, actually, I don't want her, you know, to be that colour. It's mad, but yeah, we really enjoy it. But saying that, jokes aside, we are really enjoying the process. It's really great fun, and we're really excited for next year. Yeah.
So when is it? Next summer? Or?
I think so. Yeah, yeah, that's the plan. I know
think so. I think so. I love
so.
That.
We're not after an invite.
But no, really exciting, and obviously having the album out is even more exciting.
Yeah,
so,
yeah. That's been in the works for some time as well, hasn't it?
Yeah, we've been doing it for about 18 months, 2 years. So, yeah, it's been a long time. But in that process, I actually didn't have a record deal. Well, I did, but I was coming out of it, so I had no pressure. And I didn't... And when I sort of looked at the timeline, I was thinking, well, maybe in 2022. And then before I knew it, it was 2022, and I was like, oh, my God, I've got to finish it. So at the start of the year...
We
were panicking, yeah. Everything was like a bit of a panic, but we managed to get it done. I'm so proud of the record, and, you know, it's lovely to be back with new music again, and it's been a really great few weeks.
And some of it's really personal, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is, especially the last song, Let Me Just Say, which is the last song on the album. Because we finished the album, and it was all like this all up-tempo pop music, which... You know, all my fans know that I love to do. And then I said to the guys, I was like, we haven't got any love songs on the album.
And it's called Marry Me.
And Amelia's going to be, well, this is this album, go, what? So we wrote this song called Just Let Me Say. Let Me Just Say. And it's a beautiful song. That's probably my favourite on the album. But yeah, it's just, like I said, just nice to come back with new music. And having Amelia a part of that in, you know, her own little way is nice.
Yeah. What does she make of the album?
She loves it, yeah. She
now.
Really loves it. Yeah, she loves it now. No, she's been brilliant, and she's been really, like, giving me the inspiration to write and giving me a purpose, really, with this album. So it's been really good. And I wrote with David and Jess with it. It's been fantastic. Yeah, great process. And I hope the fans are loving it, because it's... Well, I know they're loving it, because I've been seeing them the last couple of days doing album signings. It's been fantastic. So, yeah, I'm really
enjoying it. That suit would look great at the wedding, you know.
Maybe
it looks
we'll
like you've just been to a wild wedding party, in fact.
Well, that was kind of the feel for this kind of video we did, was that, you know, it's more like the after party, and, yeah, who knows, it might be like that on my wedding day, we'll see.
Well, you were talking about personal nature. One of the tracks is called I Hate You When You're Drunk,
yeah.
And you've had a bit of criticism on social media, people saying, you know, that sounds a bit controlling. And what would you say to people?
Oh, I mean, it's obviously upsetting to think that people took it that way, because it was not that intention. It was a song that I really related to in the studio, when it was a song that was wrote 8 years ago. So David had said, look at this song, it's really kind of, like, you know, it's so true, because I, at the start of January, I had a New Year's resolution, I wouldn't drink for a year. And so I've been out with my friends, my family, different people, I'm like, God, I hate you when you're drunk. So when we wrote the song, it was never about Amelia or anyone, it was just a song that we really related with at that time. So for people to take it that way, I was really upset by it. I was a bit, I can't believe people have taken it that way. So, which is a shame, because I think the song's really great. And I think when you see something that's written, it can look a lot worse. When you listen to the song and you understand the type of artist I am, it was just more in a cheeky, fun way. And, you know, if there was anyone that I would thought would got offended by, it would probably be Amelia if she thought it was about her, but it actually wasn't, so. But hey, you know, we move on.
And why did you stop drinking?
I did it just for a New Year's resolution. I thought it'd be really fun to do it for a year. And I just, yeah, I'm one of these people, when I set myself a goal and a target, and then I didn't even think really. I sort of knew I was going to propose this year. But then it was Amelia's 30th, and then it was, we had an engagement, and then obviously now the World Cup's on. I'm like, what?
And you're still sticking to it?
Stuck to it, to the point of, if anyone's cooked food in alcohol, I'm like, no, can't have it. Even though the alcohol won't even be in it when I eat it. That is how, you know, driven I am.
So does this continue beyond New Year's Eve, or do you have a massive party on the 1st of January?
Yeah, 100%, 100%, yeah. I'll be drinking again. But it's made me more aware of, you know, my body and how I feel after I've been drinking, definitely. And I was a bit wild, you know, when I was single and stuff like that. So now that I'm with Amelia and I'm happy and everything's settled, it's nice not to be drinking. It's nice to be on the other side of it and just watch everyone else having fun.
So it won't be a dry wedding?
No, it won't be. No. Amelia did say to me, you better be drinking at the wedding. I'm like, yeah. No, I definitely will be. It's just a silly thing. Well, not a silly thing. I've really enjoyed doing it, to be honest. But we'll see how I get on next year.
So you've got a wedding, an yes. album, a tour, and also you're a judge. Back on The Voice.
Yeah, I am. Yeah, I'm really exciting. I don't think I can announce the other coaches yet.
Oh, come on.
But
you can.
Well, I can't. I've been told not to. But yeah, we start filming. Actually, we're here. I'm back here in Manchester
on
Friday. Yeah, so we're back here filming it, which is really exciting. So I'm sure the fans will hear that in the next few days. But I'm hoping Sir Tom's next to me. That'd be nice.
Okay.
That must be brilliant.
Oh, Sir Tom's amazing, yeah. One of the best guys to sit with. It's funny, because I was in Cardiff yesterday doing the album signings, and I think that all my fans came to just tell me they love Sir Tom. I'm thinking, these aren't even my fans. They're Sir Tom's fans.
Can you get me Sir Tom's autograph, please?
There was a lady there, which is like, I love Sir Tom. Can you tell him I'm Auntie Julie? And
oh,
Auntie Julie loves him. And I'm like, all right, I'll tell you, Tom, yeah. Tom's brilliant. The whole crew on The Voice is fantastic. So it's nice to be back doing that. And I've just got so much going on. I've got next year, I've got Starstruck, which has already been filmed. That's coming out early next year. I'm hosting that, which is fun. So
brilliant.
It's good to be doing that again. And then I'm on tour again in April, May. So
you don't stop.
Yeah, you got to come. Come to the show.
Yeah,
definitely. Is Sir Tom going to be there?
yeah. I'll ask him, definitely.
In that case, we'll come, yeah?
All right, okay.
You mentioned the World Cup.
Yes.
I know you're a massive football fan. Oh, nervous.
I know what you're going to say. Is it coming up?
Yeah, I'm not going to say that, maybe.
I'd like to say yes, but, you know, the World Cup, you've got to play the best teams at some point. And although we've won three out of four, they haven't been the best teams in the world. We're now playing France at the weekend, so that's a massive test. But with the confidence, what I love about the World Cup, I've been to a few of the fan parks and stuff, just seeing everyone come together for it, it's been so much fun. I've really enjoyed it. I really hope England bring it home. It'd be nice, wouldn't it? It'd be so nice if finally we could bring it home.
Wouldn't it be brilliant? What about, are you going to be able to watch it on Saturday night? Are you working or are you...
No, I'm actually filming The Voice.
Oh!
I can't believe it. So I'm hoping they turn around and say, do you know what, have the evening off.
No, I'm not going to say that.
I can't imagine there'll be anyone there. We'll be pressing a red button with no audience. And I'll be like, why
surely
no
you'll have
here?
It on like a big screen somewhere off to the side.
I mean, Tom's Welsh, so he might be.
Ah, so Tom is one of them.
What?
Hey!
I can't say that. But Tom, if Tom's there, he ain't going to be bothered about watching it. So he's going to be like, no, I don't care. It'd be interesting to see what happens on Saturday. Fingers crossed we get the result. It'd be amazing to get to the semi-final. And
do you feel like if they beat France, then that...
I think the confidence we'll get from that, especially, I think we'll be flying then, and I hope then by the time we get to the final, who knows?
We get to the final, there you go, we, final.
Yes,
confidence.
Come on, I'm confident.
Good man, but you still won't drink.
I know, I can't imagine a World Cup final, I can't even have a drop.
Wow.
No. Can't, got to stick to it.
Lovely to meet you, thanks
Thank
for coming
you so
in.
So much, pleasure.
I love that discipline.
Yeah.
Single-mindedness, discipline.
Could we do it?
Yeah, definitely. I could definitely do it.
Okay. Next year?
All right, yeah.
Well, I'll be back on this side next year. I want to see how you go on.
Our counsellor. Olly's album, Marry Me, is out now and he's on tour next year.